What's going on, internet? It is me, the masked man, here for another video. And today I am doing a viewer email. The email is kind of long and I'm going to be reading most of it, so bear with me. And after I read it, I will answer the question. Okay, here I go. There's a lot of talk about introverts, shy people that stay to themselves mostly, extroverts, people that love socials and meeting new people. I just want to get your thoughts on this and discuss how much of this is relevant to American pop culture in particular. For example, you might have folks who would be more talkative, but they don't fit in with current day trends and culture. Maybe you like jazz, but if everyone in your school is in the pop EDM, I think that's electric dance music, and hip hop, then you might keep your opinions to yourself. In tribal cultures where a small group of people depend more on each other, do you think there's the same issues of introverts and extroverts, or do you think that they operate more as a group? You're from the South, and at least from what we hear, they are known for Southern hospitality, where, according to what I know, everyone waves at everyone. Everyone says hi whether they know you or not. It's not awkward to hear someone call you honey, baby, sugar, fam. You might get hugs from strangers, invited to dinner from strangers, advice, tips, opinions, and conversation easily from people you never met. I don't know how much of this is true, but in the South, I've heard they're either really nice or really not, aka racist. But in a Southern hospitality environment, if you come from a background where people are more reserved or stay to themselves, it might feel a bit intrusive. Outside of America, I've heard of cultures where random strangers might approach you for a photo or just to touch your hair. If they don't see people like you very often, Google black people in China. But the point is, your comfort level with people or being on your own, what determines this? Is it background? Is it culture? Is it personality? Is it confidence? I've also heard of neighborhoods where you might get in a fight by looking at the wrong person or speaking too freely. Maybe they'll see you as vulnerable and an easy target. And there are cultures where women do not speak to men they don't know. At least they don't start conversations. And you might need permission from her father or brothers to pursue her. So what are your thoughts on this? And what do you consider yourself to be, introvert or extrovert? Thanks. That was part one. That was part one of the question. And here is the finale. I gotta learn to start keeping my head up because it makes my thumbnails fucked up. All right, bear with me. Bear with me. I'm almost done. Okay. That was part one. Okay, this is about greetings. This is part two. I've met people that consider themselves huggers, and yes, they will hug you, even when they first meet you. I've met most commonly people who offer handshakes upon first meeting you, and second most commonly people who just head nod and say hello with no touching at all. I've met people who expect you to stop by their homes regularly to see how they're doing. Don't call in advance. Don't knock. Just stop in and see how they're getting along. And if you don't, it's kind of a cold-hearted, like you don't care about them. I've seen strangers who expect you to talk to them. And if you don't, they seem hurt. You didn't invite them. And if you don't, they seem hurt. You didn't invite them to eat with you or introduce yourself or your family and friends to them. I've also known folks who feel awkward if you call without a specific purpose. Even more awkward if you stop by without them inviting you. I've encountered strangers who feel awkward if you if you start talking to them, unless you have a specific need, like ask the time or where the bathroom is, but just saying hi or how's it going will get you a do I know you looks or why are you talking to me. So again, what governs this? How do you strive to be? Is it culture, big city versus small town? Is it personality, extrovert versus introvert? Is it past upbringing or experience? Are touchy-feely people friendly or a little intrusive? What determines this? Who sets it? Who sets what is offense and what isn't? Is it professional for a woman who is a stranger to call you dear, honey, baby? What's the line and who draws it? Thanks. Woo! My God, now that was a question for your ass. Y'all need to be like the brother that will, or the sister, I don't know, that will remain nameless. Y'all need to be like this motherfucker. When I say send me a question, this motherfucker sends me questions. Yeah, okay. Now you asked a whole lot, so it's kind of difficult to answer every point without, you know, doing a 2-hour video. And nobody wanna watch me try to do that shit again. So I'll just boil down what you said and to the main point and to the essence of what you said. Now, to answer your question, the South ain't that goddamn good. At least where I live, in Shreveport, it's not that good. Basically, in the South, you can speak to whoever you want and nobody's going to be offended. But people are not running down the street hugging each other in the South. That's ridiculous. That's not happening. It's not happening in the South. You ain't getting kissed from strangers. No strangers inviting you over to their house. It's just fairly easy to communicate. Like if I saw an older white lady and I wanted to talk to her, I could walk up to her and I could speak to her, and she wouldn't immediately feel, you know, threatened just that I was talking to her. Now, if I didn't really have a purpose, if I didn't have any reason to be talking to her, she might feel whatever. But if we were like sitting in a waiting room and I started talking to her, she wouldn't say, "Who are you? Why are you talking to me?" That wouldn't happen. But the South is not this oasis of personality. How you think a motherfucker like as antisocial as me can exist in a place that's super social? That's not real. We ain't that social. I guess in other places it's more difficult to strike up a conversation with people, so they think that this is the greatest place in the world to do that. But it's really, I imagine it's just like everybody everywhere else. People tend to go about their business. People tend to go on their way. They go about their day. Now, to answer your question, I would have to say I'm more of an introvert. I'm a nigga that ain't never had a girlfriend. How the hell am I an extrovert? I'm not an extrovert. If I was an extrovert, there's a whole lot of shit that I would have and a whole lot of shit that I would have done. I don't have a business, which I would like to have. I guess you can consider this my business and I'm building this. But, you know, being an extrovert, when I was younger, you know, I like to sing and I like to act before life crushed my spirit. But I think I kind of started off as an extrovert, and then as time went on, I became an introvert. And now I'm probably trying to become an extrovert again. But I'm kind of I'm a little bit of a hybrid. When I have something to do, I can be very extroverted. Like somebody told me, this girl that I knew from college, she told me that doing a YouTube video would be something that's difficult for her to do. She was so shocked that I was doing it. She was like, "Thumbs up for doing a YouTube video." And that was back when I was basically begging celebrities to put me on in an old channel where I made videos private and deleted some shit because no man should be acting like that. But you know, she was shocked that I was even doing this, and she was like, "Man, that takes courage." And I'm like, "Really? This takes courage? So maybe I'm a hybrid. If you see me in public, I'm probably not going to speak to you. I'm not the life of the party. I don't make a big deal about myself. It'll be hard. Unless you know me, you won't know that I'm there. So I consider myself a hybrid. I'm a little bit of both. I like to let other people talk. I like to let other people shine. I like to let other people, you know, speak. Now, the crux of your question is basically communication. And that's really the purpose of this channel, to make me a better, more skilled communicator. Because there is a serious problem in the black community, and I guess in public in general, with communication, with speaking your mind and saying what you have to say and being well understood. People, and let me go back to your question. I believe most people are shy and stay to themselves because they don't know how to express themselves. And a lot of so-called people are not really interested in people. Not like I'm interested in people, because I really want to know people. But people are just motherfuckers who like to run their mouths. They don't necessarily like to listen. They like to jawjack and bullshit about some shit that they have no intention of doing. And if you were a real communicator, if you talking to somebody in person, I'm not talking about on the internet. If you're talking to somebody in person, you know, 5 or 6 times, y'all motherfuckers should be either starting a business together or having some kind of relationship. Like if it's a man and a woman, y'all need to be getting something going on. Or if it's two men, y'all need to be starting some type of business. Don't make no sense for two men to be talking to each other, you know, on the phone, you know, in the same city for like 10 years and they ain't never done nothing together except besides watch football games. That's a waste of time. That you just want a buddy. You too goddamn old to have a buddy. So if you really communicated, if you really was having conversations about life, conversations about growing, if you were really having meaningful communication, then you would build comfort with a person really quickly. You would find out that your lifestyles were in alignment, and you would get right to building something you would want to build. And even with a man and a woman can build together. Now why haven't you built, Mass Man? Why haven't you built? Well, this is my beginning. This is the beginning of me trying to build and trying to have a conversation starter. I've never been a good communicator as far as communicating to people, talking to people. I've never been good at that. I've always been good at, you know, putting my thoughts into words. But if I see somebody across the room that I want to talk to, I can't never think of a good reason to go up and talk to them. I don't have a good reason because I'm just a dude with stuff in my head. They need to be motivated to come get it from me. I'm the most quiet guy in the room. You should notice me by how much I'm not talking. But that's my hang up. And that's a way that I have to grow. Trends in culture. I think that a lot of people that are so-called extroverts, you know, if you're talking about people who I apologize. If you're talking about people who want to be cool, but they like jazz, but people are into other things, but they're not strong enough to stand up for what they like, that's just a lack of self-confidence. They lack the self-confidence to say, this is what I like, and they lack being an individual. Now, they ain't got to force what they like on other people, but they don't have to pretend to like something that they don't. So, I just believe that if you have something that you enjoy, if you have something that you like, and other people are making you feel a certain type of way because you like jazz, that ain't cool, nobody really likes that shit, then they're not somebody who you should be associating yourself with. They should be trying to figure out what you like about it. If they're interested in you, if they care about you, if they're your friends, they should be trying to understand jazz better, or at least they should be cool with you liking it. But, you know, people try to put themselves into a box. People try to make themselves be what they think cool is. Now, I know I've talked a lot about cool, and you asked about introverts or extroverts, but I think people are what they feel that they can get away with. A lot of shy people feel like people are going to be very offended by them, or people are going to be very, dismissive of them, or they're going to reject them, and they fear rejection. I know I don't like rejection. They fear rejection, so they hold to themselves. They rather not participate and not get any contact at all, or get minimal contact, than to be rejected. Extroverts, they like to be around people. They like to be the life of the party. They like to get it cracking. They like everybody to watch them, and they don't care if they really get to know people. They don't care if people like them or not. They're going to be out there, and they're going to be in the mix. It's just a difference of mentality. It's a different way of communicating. But neither one, the introvert or the extrovert, is by design a great communicator. We got to learn how to communicate. We got to learn how to talk to people. And I don't have the answer. That's why I'm on here, asking people to send me questions, so I can take something in my real life and start becoming a better communicator, so I can show all aspects of my personality. There are some times where I'm a real introvert. There are some times where I'm a big extrovert. And it's all according to the situation. I don't always feel that I need to be quiet, even though I'm more introverted. And I don't always feel that I need to talk. But because my life doesn't allow for a myriad of experiences, it doesn't allow for a whole lot of variation, I gotta hang back, and I gotta just wait for something to happen. But I'm not waiting anymore. I'm doing something about it. So, and as far as greetings and people, because I want to answer all your questions. As far as greetings, I already said people are not running down the street hugging people in Louisiana. But greetings, that's regional. It's regional because, you know, people in L.A. have a way of greeting each other. People in New York have a way of greeting each other. People in Louisiana pretty much give you the head nod or handshake. I haven't dealt with a huge number of people in my life. Nobody ever asked me to come over their house and to check up on them and left the door open. That never happened. So I think it's all cultural. It's all regional. Some people grew up with a certain way. Apologize. Some people grew up a certain way, talking a certain way, handling their business a certain way, and they pass that, they internalize that, and they keep it going. Like, some people grew up back in a time where, if you're talking about black people, where the black community was more connected, so they want to keep that sense of connection. Well, hey, come over my house, you know, talk to me, see how I'm doing. So they keep that going. But other than that, I don't think that that's not a common thing in the South. It may be common where you're from, but I don't necessarily believe that that's some common. Yeah, you say you've met people who expect you to stop by their homes. Yeah, I've never met nobody like that. Maybe because I'm not in the church, you know. I'm not in the church like I used to be. So maybe that's like a church thing where people in church will say, "Hey, baby, come stop by my house, see how I'm doing. See how..." Because I know my sister... she would do that for the elderly in the church. So maybe that's an elderly thing. I don't know. Yeah, I think it's culture. I don't think it's big city, small city, because a big city and a small city, a big city is just a city with a lot of people in it. It's not a city that's technically big. I don't even believe that, you know, talking and hugging and all that shit is wrapped up in your personality. I think it's wrapped up in how much confidence you have in your ability to express yourself, and how strong you are to deal with the judgment. I think it's... Because I'm answering his final question, his or her final question. I don't think it's the past or upbringing or experiences, because most of the time you'll get over whatever you were dealing with. Are touchy-feely people friendly or a little intrusive? They're a little intrusive. I don't like people touching me unless they're an attractive woman. I don't like them touching me. If it's a man, they can touch my shoulder or something like that. But, you know, unless you're an attractive female, I don't want you touching me. Who sets what is an offense and what isn't? Who's ever talking? That's who sets the offense and what isn't. I mean, I hope I've answered your question satisfactorily. I believe the crux of your question is communication. And communication is something that I'm trying to figure out. I'm trying to understand. I believe that a thorough communicator has introvert and extrovert in their personality. They're strongly introverted and strongly extroverted, and they both come out at certain times. Because if you are real good at expressing yourself, you don't want to perform all the time. That, look at celebrities. They don't want to perform all the time. And if you are good at communicating, you don't want to be by yourself all the time in a corner. You want to express these wonderful thoughts that you have. I mean, as an introvert, a lot of times you'll feel like, man, if people just knew how great I was, they wouldn't be able to not fuck with me. That's how you start thinking. Man, if they knew how fantastic I was, they could not help but fuck with me, because I'm amazing. So that's what a lot of times is going on in the head of an introvert, but they don't have the tools to express it. So I don't want to go talk long, long, long. I just want to say what I had to say. I hope that answers your question. Let me know what you think about my answer. Leave it in the comments. Rate the video, like it, dislike it. Be honest. Subscribe to my channel if you want to keep up with the videos that I'm making. If you want to send me an email, you can send me an email at themrmassman@gmail.com. You can follow me on Twitter or find me on Facebook at The Mr. Mass Man. That is all I have to say about this subject. So I will see you in the next video.